I'm going to talk about a new development we have been doing, which is basically we called the Wanda API. API stands for Application Programming Interface. I'll explain a little bit later on this. As you see, there is a question dialogue. You have all been using this already. You can use it at the end. I will start answering your questions, and there will also be a possibility to do some live Q&A. The contents of today's presentation will be, first I will be explaining what is the Wanda API. Then we'll be looking at what you can do with it, possibilities of it, and then we're looking into the structure of how it is structured, setting an ID, what's also about the possibilities and how to use it, and then I will end with some examples. So, and this is how basically the current Wanda user interface is structured. Basically, all what you see is this side. You see the iGraphics flowcharter with the Wanda interface, the in and output, the property selection property window next to it, which is basically used as our user interface. And behind the screens, which you don't see, is some Visual Basic code, which enables that you can create in and out, create input files, and you can read the output, and then can visualize the results. Next to that, we have the calculation core, which is basically Fortran code, in which we have a steady and unsteady executable, and for the parameter script, we have an executable. And basically, what it does, it reads the input file, does the calculations, and puts the results back in the WDO file, which is the, basically the output file. This is basically how it is now structured, and this is basically also, with, for now, we keep this, so that the current user interface can still be used. But what we have been doing is basically create a Wanda API, an application program interface. And basically that is a library of classes and functions which you can use to access and edit the Wanda files. And we made it in such a way that you can do it from most common programming languages. So for example, you can do it from Python, but you can also do it from MATLAB, but also for example, C#, it's also possible. And we also have a C interface, so it enables us also to go to other programming languages. You only need to make some kind of wrapper around it. So with this library of classes, we can basically load a Wanda case. We can manipulate it. We can make changes to it. We can save it. We can run simulations. So that makes opens a whole world of possibilities what we can do. So for example, we can create figures. If I run the Wanda case, we can open, we can read it with this Wanda Mono API, we can get the results, and we can make a plot. So you see example above here. And looking a little bit further, you can also completely automatize your figure creation. If you have to do a report, you normally have to do, have done a lot of cases, you have to have a lot of figures. And now you do, you need, yeah, at the moment you need to do a copy of paste of all the figures, but if you can automatize it, makes your job a lot easier. But as I said, you can also adjust models, and you can run simulations. You can also build models from scratch. So if you have data in, for example, a GIS database, you can read this and you create a Wanda model. Here on the right, on the bottom right, you can see an example of this. So I made a GIS model of a non-existing pipeline system. And then with this Wanda API, I created a Wanda model out of it, which is basically then can be used to run simulations. As I said, you can change models, so you can also do parameter studies, but you can also think about coupling Wanda to other software. So they get the results from the other software and then run your simulations and put the results back to this software. So basically you'll be able to create a kind of your own user interface. You have the freedom to do this with this Wanda API. But also more other tasks like a model calibration. If you've done measurements, you can make a script which you can basically easily run several simulations. Based on the results, you create new simulations and that you use to calibrate your model. Or completely other possibility, some uncertainty analysis, Monte Carlo simulations is also possible. And we already made some example scripts to do this. And you can see here on the right, you can see the result of it. You can see the distribution of the pressure for a large number of simulations. that can give insight in the robustness of your design. So with this WANDA model API, you can do a lot of things. And basically, so you're up to your imagination what you can do, and you can play around with this and test. But I think it can make your life really much more easy, especially if you're doing search analysis. And I've already been testing it, of course, for the past half year about, and using it in projects to test it and to see what's possible. And it really made my life more easy and enabled to do a lot of things. So I'm really enthusiastic about this, and I hope you also will be. So let's dive a little bit into the structure of this API. And for that, I'm going to jump to this. Basically, we also, of course, created help functions on this. And that's basically kind of a web-based help function, which is automatized, created based on the code we have made and the comments we put in there. And as you can see, we have several classes which can be accessed. And the main class is, of course, the WANDA model. And I will be also later showing an example where we'll be using this. And in the WANDA model, we have WANDA components, WANDA nodes, WANDA signal lines if you have control. And a component on this has different properties. So for example, you have a component, you have a pipe, and the pipe has an inner diameter, and the inner diameter is a property. And you have also sometimes a property has is a table. So for example, the profile table, that's a WANDA table. Basically, by accessing these different levels, you can access, for example, if you go, you get the model, you say, okay, give me a component. And then you can say, okay, give me this property. And if you go into the property, you can say, for example, I want the value. So if you have an inner diameter, you say, I want to have the value. But you also have the possibility to set the value, which is also a function here. So here, set scalar. So then you can change the value. So basically, it is really easy structured. It's not that difficult and very logical. And of course, you have the help. So you can just click on the component or the property to see what functions are available there, what you can do with it. So basically, the structure is you have a WANDA model. In this WANDA model, you have basically WANDA components and WANDA nodes and WANDA signal lines. And all of these are from the WANDA item class, derived from that. Because, for example, the component, the node, and the signal all have a name. So that we combined in one class, which is the WANDA item. Now, all these different components or different items have properties, and they can have a table. So basically, that's the basic structure. And based on that, you can get a property, get a table, get a component, and so on, and manipulate them, or ask them for the values, or get the time series. So let's go jump into some examples. I want to show you two examples. One is creation of figures, and one is creation of WANDA model. And for that, I will be using Python. And I'm using, at the moment, Spider, which is part of the Anaconda package. And of course, you're free to use any package which can run Python. The only thing which you need to ensure that it is Python 3.7, and it's a 64-bit version of Python and not a 32-bit version. So here already I made some basic coding. So first, we need to import, of course, the WANDA API, which is called PyWANDA. And of course, first you need to install it, and we will be, of course, handing out installation instructions if you want for the installation, how to do that. So since I want to make some plot, I'm also importing the plot library, which is called the matplotlib. But that is, I'm not going to detail that. If you want to know more, just use Google, and that makes, then you can easily find it. So, and then what we need to do, we need to define the WANDA bin directory. And for me, it's installed in the program files, deltares WANDA 4.6. I'm already testing, of course, the newest version. So I'm using Wanda 4.6 here. And you need to define your Wanda case. So I have here this, basically the standard sewage transient example, which you also can find in your Wanda installation that I'm going to import. And what I'm going to do, I'm making a Wanda model object. So you're basically calling the Py the Wanda model. Basically, that's the only thing which you call in the Py Wanda. And yeah, you say I want a Wanda, you have to give a Wanda case and a Wanda bin directory. And basically, I can run the script already. And basically, what it does, it loads the model. And here at the end, which is also important, it closes the model. And this is important because if you don't do that, then you might have a problem that the case becomes corrupt. So you always need to end with model close. But basically, this is not very interesting. I just open and close the model. Let's go see if we can fetch some time series because this model has already run. So it has already output data. And the first thing we need to do is tell to load the output data. And we have done this because it's not, if you load a model, you not always want to load the output data because that can take some time, especially for long simulation. So you have to specify it yourself. If you have run a simulation, then it's automatically loaded. But otherwise, if you just load a model, you need to always reload your output data. So then I'm going to create a component object. And I'm going to do that by going to saying to the model, get one component. And then I need to specify the name of the component. So for now, I'm going to say PyP1. I want to have PyP1. So if we make a short jump to the Wanda model, which I have open here. So you might know this example. This is a sewage transient example. So two simple sewage pumping stations pumping the water to a sewage treatment plant. And I'm saying, okay, I want to have this pipe, which is called PyP1. But then, of course, I'm not interested in the pipe. Basically, I want to have a property. So I'm going to get the pressure 2 of this pipe. So I'm going to say to the pipe, get property. And just say pressure 2. So and then now I can just run it, see what happens. As you can see, I get an error here, reload output. I made a typo, so if I put here T, then it runs. You see here on the right-hand side in the console, it runs the file completely, but still not doing anything. So what I want to do, I want to get the time series. So what I'm going to say, pressure to get series. And let's see if it does something. So I'm making a print statement. So let's see if everything works correctly. Yes. And now you see I printed here the pressure 2 of pipe P1. I printed it here. Now I should note, as you see, I put here SI, and that's because all values set into the are getting back from the Wanda model API are in SI units. That was for us the easiest way to do it and also makes it clear what unit it is. But you not always want that, so we have also the possibility to convert it. So let's see how we can do that. What we're going to do then is say we use the get unit vector. Basically what it do, you get the unit vector of in which of the units which is set in the case. So in this case, the case is set to bar G. So it will be a factor of 10 to the power minus 5. And I need to specify here how X should vary. So basically here, I am just changing the time series from SI units to case units. What I can do then, make a plot out of it. Then we plot the time series. And let's test this. And if you look here now on the right here, you can see the graph. But the y-axis, that's in the case units, but this is still not time steps, but it's a number of points. So we want to also, if we want to also add a time step, that's also possible. Then we're going to say the time axis, we're going to say model get time steps. And basically this will produce a time series of all the time steps, also based on the output increment you put in the case, so that it is the same length as your time series. And if we run this now, just make one, let's put an underscore here. If you now look again at the graph, you can see now the bottom axis is in seconds, because it's now at 20 seconds. If you jump to one now, you can see also the simulation time is 20 seconds. If I plot here the pressure two, it's a little bit difficult to compare, but see about 9 seconds there is the minimum. If you jump back to right here, about 9 seconds there is the minimum, and it's about minus 0.6. So you can see that is the correct time series. And of course, now the graph is only shown here, but you can also save the graph and put nice axes in it, put a grid on it. You can put multiple lines in one figure and so on. But for the purpose of the demo, I'm not going to jump into that. What I can anyhow say, we made already an example, which also includes this kind of stuff. So that makes it easy to have basically a head start for you to create easily create figures. But you can just see with also a couple of lines of code, you can already create easily a figure and get data out of your system. So it's not that difficult to do. It's very logical structured, because first you're going to say, okay, I need a component. So you can say get component, then you need to get the property, and then in this property you need to get the series to be able to set it. And then here we have some conversion, of course, from SI to the case units, and then we can do already the plotting. So that is for the plotting of time series. Now I want to jump into a example where we're going to build a model. So basically we start by creating an empty model, and that's how we do that, is basically by, again, we have to call this model, and then the Wanda case we're putting in is a non-existing Wanda case. So I call it number four. And what it does then, it basically creates an empty Wanda case for you. And then I'm going to add components. I'm going to put it later on it. And at the end, what we need to do, we need to call the save model input, because basically everything up to the moment you put save model input is done in memory. So if I don't save it, nothing is saved to the file, and the file will still be empty. So let's start by adding some components. So add component, but then we need to give the name of the component. So for that, if we go, for example, to one, if we want to, for example, put in the bound age, then what we need to do, you have here to give the type name. So you don't give bound age, but you have to give bound age space reservoir. So that's what we need to put in here. And you have to really also pay close look at the capitals, because that's really important, because it's case sensitive. But then we're not there. We also need to define a position where we want to have the component in the Wanda model. So basically that's in this diagram where you want to position it. And that's a little bit the tricky part, because basically you need to define a position, which is basically two values. It's an X and a Y. And this is in iGraphics coordinates, and that's a little bit difficult to match to the real measures you see here. but you can just test and play with it. And a distance of about 5 to 10 between components, that's a nice distance to have. Next to that, the X units are normally, so that's just positive, but the Y units, you have to put it in negative, and that's because basically you're going down with the Y. So this is the X and this is the Y, and the Y goes down, so that's why it is negative. If you put it positive, it will be above your canvas. So it makes it difficult to find. So that's why you have to put a negative number here. So let's see what happens if I do this, if I run the script. It has run. So then what I can do, I can see here, this is the file I just created, and I can open it. And there you see, I have a model with a bound edge. So that is very interesting, but of course we can add more components to it. So what I'm going to do, again, we create a new model. I want to be able to use this bound edge also later on. So what I do, this add component gives the component back. So now I store it in a variable so I can use it. I'm also going to add a pipe. If I'm correct, it is this. So let me just check to be sure. Let's get the pipe component, see. Pipe liquid, so yeah, I have to put brackets and a capital around it. And if you do it wrong, you can just get an error message back. Okay, I don't know this component. So that's, you get a proper error message back. What I need to do, I don't want to put it at the same location as the bound edge, so I'm going to put it at a different location. So I change the X coordinate to 10. So then I have a pipe and a bound edge. And of course I want to connect these two. So what I'm going to do, I say model connect. And I'm going to say, okay, bound edge. And then I have to say, specify the connect point I want to connect it to. So I want connect point one. I'm saying pipe and also connect point one. So if I run this script, ready, but run, no errors. So then I can open this model. And it has to build a diagram. And what you see, you have the bound edge, we have the pipe, and both are connected with an edge node. So basically, so you can build easily compare your model. And of course, you can extend this by saying, okay, pipe gets property, say inner diameter, let's say set scalar, and I want to have an inner diameter of 0.5 meters, so 500 millimeters. Again, you need to specify it in SI units. Let's create a new model, see if this works. If I open it, if I click now on the pipe, you can see it's a nice inner diameter of 500 millimeters. So this is just a small example. I also made a more complete example. Basically, this is also one of the examples which will be delivered as an example with the Wanda model API. Basically what I do here, I can zoom in a little bit more to make it more clear. I first add a bound edge and then I set the head there. Then I'm going to add some pipes, also set the different properties of the pipe. Then I connect the pipe to the bound edge. And then I also set the elevation of the node because you need to set that. And then I'm adding 9 other pipes. So I have your loop, adding pipes, connecting them. And then at the end, I put a bound edge, set, also connect that. And then I save everything and then I run steady. And then I want to know what the discharge is to the system. I have to specify here. new model name. And if I run this, it takes some more time, of course, because it has to store more pipes in it. But here you can see here you get the answer. It has a flow rate of 0.38 cubes per second. So, and of course, I can also open this case in the user interface. Take some time, it has to build a diagram. And because it builds a diagram, all the output has been thrown away, but I can calculate steady. And first of all, you can see here the model basically with the 10 pipes and the mount H. And you can see here the flow rate. And let's switch to SI units, which is 0.38, as we have also seen here in Python. So that's correct. So basically here you can see that you can easily build a model. And now I'm just putting in the data, making up myself. But of course you can make an Excel sheet, for example, with the data in it and read that and build your model from that. So, but you can also use other data sources or whatever you like. So there's a lot of possibilities with this Wanda Model API. So I just shown you some example of how to create figures, creating of a Wanda model. And of course, there's a lot of other possibilities, but for now, I don't have the time to also jump into that. But for you, good to know, this Wanda API that will be released in Wanda 4.6. And we're planning that for the fall. We don't have yet an exact date, but we'll be informing you about that. Next to that, I want to point out that the Delft Software Days are coming up. It's from the 5th to the 15th of November. And during this Software Days, there are also Wanda courses. So we have a basic course for just basic Wanda usage, introduction into Wanda, advanced course on modeling techniques, more into the parameter script, control usage, and so on. And the last thing is on the 15th of November, there will be a course on running Wanda from Python. Basically what I showed you today, but then we're going to into more depth. And of course, you're also going to yourself play with that and dive into that. And if you want to know more, just go to the softwaredays.deltares.nl, and there you can find more information and you can also register for that. So thank you for your attention. And now I want to spend some time if you have any questions. And we can do that via live chat. So if you have a question, just raise your hand and then I will unmute your microphone. You can post your questions and then I will try to answer that.